my channel. Hey. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome. I'm so happy. I woke up in such a great mood today. The sun is shining. I self-tanned and I just like feel like a golden goddess. I just feel great. And yeah, so I just wanted to start a vlog. I'm just in a happy mood. So hello, it is a little bit dark in here. So sorry, I just arrived to the gym and I have to go inside, but I wanted to start the vlog. Little update, I'm back at the gym. I just started like a week ago and you have to make an appointment to go to the gym, which it's not that big of a deal. It's like takes like 10 seconds. In my gym, only 44 people can work out at once. So, and usually there's only like 25. And it's like, it's great. Honestly, like I feel super comfortable. It's just great. I'm so pumped, so happy. My spirits are lifted. I just feel so good. So I'm gonna go ahead inside and I'll bring you guys with me. But I need a coat because it's freaking cold. So, oh, this is really cold. I left this jacket in my car and now this is like as cold as outside, but whatever. There is a mask mandate. So you have to wear like your mask the whole time, which I am very okay with. It's not too big of a deal to me to like have to wear my mask while working out. I don't think it's like too awful or anything. Here's my little masky mask. It's so cute, honestly. It's a body positivity mask. I don't even know if you guys will see that. Body positivity. There are naked ladies on my mask. I am full of energy. I haven't even taken pre-workout yet. I am so pumped. It's leg day. Bring you guys with me. Also, I cut my hair. You can't see it right now. I'll show you guys later. I'm great, crazy, but I'm just really happy and I'm in a great mood. So let's go to the gym. I got a mask up. All right, ski
leg day.
Workout complete. That was a good workout. Kind of hard to get like my full workout recorded because I am super limited on time. Like I said before, like you have to make an appointment and the appointment's only for 1 hour and it takes me like 30 minutes to stretch, like just to get ready for my workout. So most of the time you can like do like a walk-in for the following hour if you want to keep working out, but that isn't like guaranteed. So sometimes I feel a bit rushed in my workout, but today it was super easy to get my time extended and I had a good workout. I'm super hungry. It's so nice to be back in the gym, but it also kind of sucks like the gym could get taken away from me at like any second. But I'm very thankful and grateful that it's open now and I can work out there now, because you know my garage, it's almost like working out in my garage makes me more angry about the situation of like not having a gym. So with that being said, I did buy I bought a stationary bike because I don't know if the gym is gonna close or if cardio is gonna be available to me, because I feel like with working out at home, like not having cardio was like the biggest issue because it was dark and rainy every day. I don't walk outside in the dark. So this last like lockdown for me, I live in Washington, by the way, this last like lockdown, it was over Christmas and winter and all that, so I like literally did absolutely no cardio at all, like zero cardio. Movement was not planned for in my garage when they built my house. Yeah, it's just a little bit frustrating, but you know, I'm really trying to stay positive, really trying to stay positive. So I bought a bike, that's exciting, and when I get home, I'm gonna shower and put it together. Yeah, that's a little, tiny little mini update. Gym was good, bought a bike, and I'm gonna put it together with you guys when I get home. I'm like so sweaty. I'm very happy I'm sweaty. Okay, I'm home and I actually ran to the grocery store really quickly just to get a few things because I went grocery shopping the other day, but I like forgot a few things. A little update. I am not following macros any longer right now. I was just kind of going through like a really negative mental headspace while following macros, and I know like so many people relate and have gone through it too, so I know I'm not the only one. But to make a long story short, basically I was doing it for about 6 months and it was so up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down, because with macros you have to be perfect pretty much to like meet that daily goal, and to me like it was just too much pressure. That's all I would think about, and like that's what my mind would be consumed with was macros. And I started overeating so much at nighttime, like definitely binging. I don't want to talk too much about that because I know that's a very sensitive topic and I don't want this video to trigger anyone or anything, but yeah, it was just not good mentally for me. I am back to eating a bit more balanced and it's really awesome. Like I haven't overeaten or like binged since like the day I decided to stop tracking macros. I feel really good about that decision, and just know macros isn't for everyone. I learned a lot with tracking macros for that long. Like I learned a lot about portion control and like how much food your body actually needs to thrive. I took everything I learned into consideration and I am just really eating intuitively right now, and definitely I feel really good. That's a little update about the macros. Macros can be super beneficial for results, but for me, I just don't think like having it be a daily thing for 6 months is good for me. So let me show you guys what I got at the store. So I got some pop chips. I got some Reese's miniature cups. I just love Reese's. I put these in the freezer and it makes like eating your treat or your sweets, it takes longer to eat it. It like makes you enjoy it more and indulge more, so then it kind of helps me not overeat. So I got those, and then I also got these bars. I picked up some more salami. I get the reduced sodium salami. I actually think it just tastes better. This is definitely a staple for me in my fridge. And then I just got some goat cheese as well because I can eat goat cheese. It does not hurt my stomach or make me bloated at all. And it is so good in salads. So I got one that's like blueberry vanilla and then one with honey. And I also got some frozen strawberries and bananas. And I got some frozen blueberries because I want to start making some protein shakes in the morning. I got this huge thing of Super Greens blend. I love this a lot. It's like my favorite salad mix and I've been super into salads. They are just so good. I love salads so much. You can put so much in them. And I've got some spinach. Spinach can go in everything. It's like the easiest way for me to get my greens in is I just like throw spinach in like all my meals. Lastly, got some chicken. I'm actually gonna cook up two of these today. So there's my grocery haul and there's my little update about not following macros anymore. It was definitely like a little bit nerve-wracking like sharing that I wasn't gonna track them anymore because I kind of felt defeated that I like it didn't work for me. Don't feel bad if macros don't work for you. It really is tough. Like it really is hard and it's really like mentally draining. It can be really good for your body and you learn a lot while tracking them. There's definitely pros and cons to everything, and yeah, this video is just kind of like an update about everything what I'm doing, and a 2021 goal update as well because it is 2021. It's my first video in 2021. I just wanted to share my goals with you guys because in the past I have shared my goals and they were just so specific. They were so specific that it was hard to achieve. My goals now are very simple, like so simple. They're just like the daily things that I want to do to make me reach my big goal. My first goal weight is just getting back to my pre-pandemic weight. I was in between 205 pounds and 210 pounds. I went back and forth between those 5 pounds for a bit. I don't know how much weight I want to lose like in total. I just know like I want to reach my pre-pandemic weight and then see see where I go from there. Right now, my goal is to lose weight. That's like my big goal, but I don't really focus on just that. I focus on the daily things instead. The daily things that I do to achieve my big goal, which is lose weight, is I drink a gallon of water a day, making 3 meals a day and eating them. I journal, meditate, and do affirmations. Affirmations have really helped me learn how to like switch my perspective and like kind of brush off some negativity. Affirmations really, really helped me, and I do them daily now. Move my body daily, some type of movement. That is the goal. Oh, and right now I'm doing the Gymshark 66 challenge. I have a goal of completing it. Like, I have never completed a challenge before because I have given up like in the middle, the beginning. And so it's day 25 of the Gymshark 66 challenge. The first week, it like took me so long to like just start everything. Like, took me like 5 days to get a workout in. It took me forever to start drinking a gallon of water a day. I did not meditate every day. I did not do my affirmations. It took me at least 2.5 weeks to like start having a routine with my goal. So I just want to tell you guys and share with you guys, it's not gonna be perfect from day one. You have to know that, you have to remember that. I mean, I bet there are some people out there that can just completely follow something from day one and be perfect, 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 but that is not normal, that's not reality. They're a special breed, they're not normal human beings. If you're in the same boat as me and it takes you a bit to get going and develop an actual routine that will stay, just remember, keep going. If I didn't keep going, I wouldn't be where I am right now. If I didn't keep going those 2 weeks and kept trying to develop my routine and kept trying to drink my water and focus on my goals, I wouldn't be where I am right now, which is only, you know, I'm 25 days in now, and now I feel so peaceful. I feel happy. I feel motivated. I feel determined. My goals feel very close, and like I can touch them, and like, I know that sounds weird, but like my goal feels so close and I just feel so good, and I'm finally like in a really great routine now for the most part. Like, I'm still not perfect. Like, I still, like today I forgot to eat breakfast before the gym. Like, it's just like little things like that. It's okay if you mess up, but if you mess up and you give up, then the trick is with any goal, not just fitness, not weight loss, not any, like anything specific, just goals in general. If you keep going through like the bumpy road in the beginning and like messing up, like making some mistakes, you will get to your goal. You will. Like, time does not stop. You wake up every day and you can choose what to do that day, and you can choose your goal. You can choose to work on you. You can choose to better yourself. You can choose the things that will make you happy. And it's so strange because we all, you know, you would think like, yeah, of course I would choose the things that make me happy, but that's not the case. Like, I am living proof. Especially if you struggle with depression like me, doing the things that you love can almost be the hardest things to do. The main thing I'm trying to say right now is just, as long as you don't give up, you're gonna reach your goal. Strive for consistency. Consistency meaning you don't have to work out at 9 a.m. every day for 2 hours. Just work out, move your body every day. Like, that is consistent. It doesn't have to be so precise, and that is a mistake that I have made so many times with writing goals and like just being on my weight loss journey. Like, just being too specific to the point where like you can't achieve it, like unless everything else in the world is like with you on that goal. You know, like, shit happens. There are so many lives that are living in this world, and sometimes your plan is not going to go the way you want, and you just have to figure out how you can still get your stuff done and stay consistent. And if you make a mistake, if you skip your workout, whatever the mistake is, you wake up the next day, you choose to work on you, you choose your goals, and you make the choice of what you're gonna do that day, and you can choose if you're gonna keep going. I am going. I am not gonna give up. And every time I pushed through like really not wanting to continue, or I just wanted to give up, every time I didn't, I became stronger, I became more confident, it became easier the next day to follow through with my wants and my goals and my needs. It just makes you stronger when you get through it. And so I just really, really, really want you all to know you don't have to be perfect. You just have to do it. Like, just try. Just like try your best. And then your goals will come with time. It is not a race. I know I'm not like prepping for a physique competition. Like, I am just trying to live my life and be happy and love myself and be confident. Thing, I'm not trying to compete. I literally just want to be healthy and happy and motivated and confident. That is what I am now. I feel really good. Anywho, I am going to make some lunch and I'll see you guys in a second.
I just found this at Sprouts and I am so excited to try it. It's protein rice from Bonza, and I use Bonza all the time. I love their protein noodles. It's like what I live off of, and I am so excited to try this. So I'll let you guys know how it is. I'm gonna make it right now. Okay, here's the final product. So I just have turkey, onions, peppers, and spinach, avocado, and that Bonza rice. I haven't tried it yet. I'll let you guys know how it is though when I try it. And I made two meals at once. So I made this meal and then I made tomorrow's lunch because I will be working and I won't be home. So I have my lunch all made.
I decided to go for a little walk after I ate because I was so full. So I'm just walking. It's like 2.5 miles, almost 3 miles, I think. Yeah, that's all.
All right, I just ate one of these and I wanted to tell you guys about them. So good. It's so good. If you like chocolate though, oh my gosh, it's so good. I am about to head downstairs to go put together my bike. Let's go. All right, so I'm in my garage. Here's my workout stuff in my bag. I'm selling this though, but someone hasn't bought it yet. So let's put this thing together.
I can't find the hardware pack. Like, I looked through everything.
Howdy. So I just talked to an Amazon customer service rep and unfortunately they can't just like send me the hardware because they definitely left out the hardware in the bike, but it's okay. I'm just gonna return it and get my money back because it was like $330. I'll just hold on to that and I don't know, I'll buy it again when I need to or something. I don't know. Anywho, I have to return it and it's gonna be super easy though. They're just gonna like pick it up at my house outside. So it's gonna be like super easy, no hassle return. So thank you, Amazon. It was Claude and Asia. Thank you, Claude and Asia, for all your help. It is like 10:45 and I had that ice cream and I just like am not that hungry today. I don't know why. That's the thing with macros, like even if you weren't hungry you had to eat like a huge ass meal and that was like so hard. Yeah, but I'm just gonna go to bed and I want to show you guys my new haircut, but it's like not styled. Oh, and in the morning, I want to show you guys what I do in the mornings now. I have like a whole morning routine. So nice. It's so chill. It like gets my day going in the best way possible. It's like very calm. Oh, it's great. So I'm going to see you guys in the morning super early. See you at 5:45. I'm still just like in a great mood. Even my bike not working like can't get me in a bad mood. I'm just like so happy in a great mood. I'm gonna stop talking and get to bed.
Good morning. Here is my new hair. I didn't wash it this morning because I just didn't want to. It's like 6:15 right now. I woke up at 6. I didn't get out of bed at 5:45, but that's okay. I'm still up. So the first thing I do in the morning before I like eat or drink coffee or anything is I drink like a whole water bottle. This is only 20 ounces. If I have my hydro flask, I'll drink like half of it. But if I don't, I'll just drink a whole bottle of this. I just have like a super chill morning and I just like kind of prep my day mentally, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna drink some water.
I'm making my coffee. It's just like super simple. What I put in my coffee is a creamer right here. This is the Belgian style chocolate toffee. It's really good. I think it's like lactose free, but it's not completely dairy free, but I've never noticed like any issues with it. Also, what I put in my coffee is collagen. My hair grows like crazy when I take this daily. I just put one scoop in my coffee and I don't taste a difference. Some people say they do. I don't taste a single difference. I think it just tastes like coffee. Creamer. Alrighty, Ruski. I'm like living in this sweatshirt right now. Okay, so in the morning, I just do a few things like just to make my day go smoother, make me feel a bit more prepared. One thing I have been doing that has been helping me so much is like planning my day the night before. I wrote this out last night. I should have showed you guys, I don't know why I didn't. I do write out my meals and I think this is just so nice because then I don't have to be like, oh my God, what am I supposed to eat? So this is what I have for today, all of my to-dos, and I write out all of my meals that I'm gonna be eating like while I nanny, and then I'll eat when I get home. I don't know why I wrote that. So good. Oh, because I ate this yesterday and it was so good. And then like I want to post on Instagram because I'm doing the Gymshark 66 challenge. This is my daily little list. So I don't go on social media in the morning like at all. I have this thing on my phone called downtime and it's actually really nice. Like you can't go on like anything, you can't text people, you like can't do anything. I've been doing this for like 3 weeks, but now I feel like I used to be so addicted to just going on Instagram like the second I woke up, and now I can just like think about my day and like other thoughts. Like I'm not just like thinking about scrolling. So it's just nice to like be more present, kind of enjoy the morning and like the quietness, and use this time to my advantage. That's my morning, and I really hope you guys enjoyed this little vlog. Hope you enjoyed my little bike mishap. I wish I could have put that together with you guys, but it'll just have to be in a different vlog. This is my little goals update. Consistency over perfection. That's always the right way to go. Be consistent, not perfect. Do your best, try your hardest. You got it. You can do anything you want. I will see you guys in the next vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I love you all and have a great day. Don't forget who the frick you are. You're awesome. You're worth the time and effort for you to reach your goals. You can do it. I love you guys. Have a good day and thanks for watching. Bye.